Hello, welcome back to Outward. So it's fun time again, and this time I will do the boss in this Cabala of the Wind Temple. But it's so silly because I didn't. So I spent about 3 or 4 hours trying to get in, but it didn't work. So someone on the forums told me. So either way, you have to be really, really open-minded about the bosses in order to enter them. So this will be number 6 for me, and there are at least 2 more. So to enter this boss, you just have to, you know, enter the place, safely climb down. Okay, safely jump down, and then you have to get poisoned, which is the weird thing. Because if you want to do this, you have to buff up before, and then you can actually enter the boss. But it's kind of a weird roundabout. Oh. Okay. Let's hide in here so I can finish my buffing because. Hey, let me finish. That guy is so mean. He will hunt you relentlessly like that. So you really have to buff up before you enter his little domain, his little dungeon. But that's kind of hard to do. So you really have to kill the small guys. Okay, he's a smart one. Haha. He figured it out. So yeah, this is kind of doing it the harder way because I just wanted to show you how not to do it. So yeah, as you can see, you'll be surrounded by enemies, so you can kill them if you want to, but I suggest you leave the last one alive, the big one, in the central room. I don't have time to play kids. Go. Leave me alone. It's getting closer to me. I don't care about you. Oh, but I do care about the big guy. Yeah. So you have to get hit and get poisoned. So that's the really hard part. It's not really hard, but it's kind of like, you know, you have to be poisoned to enter the boss, but then you'll be weakened. But what's the matter? Do you not poison? Hey? Okay, here it is, we are poisoned. So now you can enter the boss without any problems, but as I said, you might want to clear the area first. Or I don't know, it's up to you. But, you know, the first time I came here, I always killed all the monsters and then tried to figure out how to enter the place, so... And here he is, he is all beautiful. Hey, I'm saying nice things about you. Ooh. What was that? Kamehameha? Well, that was a big attack. Yeah, so he's my favorite boss so far, as you can see. Why are you not doing damage to me? Oh, he's fully elemental damage? So what? Oh, he must be okay, so he does, I think, only ethereal damage or something crazy like that. So his attack pattern is not so hard to figure out. Okay, so we have another boss that is completely or almost immune to frost damage. Which is bad for me, but luckily for me, I came prepared this time. So yeah, this is the first time I'm fighting him. Will you stop doing that? Ooh. So this is a bit harder because he has the range on you. Okay, so you have to be careful of that skill. And I'm not really prepared to fight him, but he seems to be very resistant to elemental attacks. Okay, so take this time to heal up. That was lucky, right? And don't try to run too much from him, because you saw that elemental attack. It's crazy, right? Okay, so... Either way, if you run, you'll shit your weapon, so that's another problem. So, when you knock him down, you can hit him a couple of times, but remember to run away. Now do your little elemental attack. Yeah, that pattern is easy to figure out, as you can see. I don't roll because I have the big backpack on. I prefer to sidestep because I can also attack when I sidestep. And he also does this little back. Okay, that's bad. He also does that little backflip, I mean sidestep, where he steps back or backstep or whatever you want to call it. So he's actually even more dangerous than the other ones, just because of all these mechanics. Okay, let's try to kill him, because even though he's a lot of fun to fight and you know, I appreciate a good fight like this, it's time to end it because I want to see what's behind him. Okay, let's not underestimate him because that's a very bad thing. Well, I'm out of buffs, which is another bad thing. Okay, let's put, at least have the immunity. Yeah, this is the typical boss fight, you run away a lot. Oh, okay, so this is the first time I was fighting him, so that's why I was so afraid of him. Because most of the times I don't want to practice a lot, because as you can see, their patterns are easy to figure out. But let's look at this beautiful, immaculate, ethereal being. So this is mostly a ghost weapon. This halberd. Anyway, let's go for the interesting stuff, because this is something new here. Actually, first of all, let me check out something. Let's put our good comfy clothes on. So this is just for relaxation. So now we can... Okay. I have a feeling that I was poisoned, so I just had to quickly look over there. So I was panicked because what? If I'm poisoned again, I will die. But he doesn't do poison damage. I think he only does ethereal damage, and he does lots of it. So this is where you enter. He's a good guy. I feel bad about killing him. But yeah, let's get our reward and look at this crazy stuff here for a moment. So... I have a few theories about this, so sorry about the boring. Okay, let's get our loot. Oh, that was... I think they modified the drops on the bosses, because that was a very, very small amount of materials we got from this one. I think this is our friend, the Immaculate, who actually gave us his Dreamer Halberd. Because for some reason, only he carries the birds with him, so I'm pretty sure he's the same guy, and this is some kind of weird dimension. Because look at that one. I think that's fungus growing or something, I don't know. This is some crazy place, so right here. And that looks like a big scene. You know, this reminds me of something, I don't know, some horror game. The Darkness Within, or what was it called, that shooting game that looked like a bit like Resident Evil? Darkness Within? No, I don't know, where that crazy killer photographed his victims to be completely stuck in time like this. Anyway, this is a very curious scene, because it can mean a lot of things or it can mean nothing. So, I think this was the friend that gives us the halberd, but he seems to be stuck in a weird dimension. And that might be, I don't know, the ancestor of the Immaculate ones, maybe one of the original ones. And he's keeping him here prisoner. Remember, this is the end of the game, so he already gave you the halberd, you already meet him, so... I don't know, maybe he was taken prisoner by that guy in order to do something, to punish him, because he was not like the other ones. As you can see, the birds are alive in this cage. The bird is alive, so yeah, he also has a lot of books, and you know, the Immaculate don't really read books, they mostly attack and kill people. But this one has the books, has the candles, has a nice bed, a table, of course, and a little board here. So yeah, I think this is our friend, and he was... I don't know, maybe he's tortured for eternity, or he's just stuck here. And anyway, you can see some of the writing on the book here. So yeah, the developers really went out of their way to do something. I don't know, maybe this means nothing, or maybe it means something for the lore. Anyway, let's look at this finger for a while. But this is like the normal arena that we find in Monsoon. But let's look a bit at the pictures. Of course, the vases made by the Ash Giants, I think. So that's a picture of that's a windmill, and those are a few ships, I think. And that's another pretty picture. Anyway, this is a very weird and interesting location. I hope we can do more to save our friend, because I don't want to leave him like this. We have to save him, he's our friend. Yeah, look at our face. And besides, when we know more, when I know more, or when the developers tell us more, I'll let you know about it. But again, the Immaculate ones are one of my favorite factions, beside the Ash Giants. So I hope we'll see more of them. But now, let's have some fun, because I want to show you what I've been working on, because the game is not all find secrets and be stressed out about it. No, 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 it's fun sometimes. So let me show you something that is like a little challenge to me. So you know about Code Sonic. So let's see. Ta-da! I also have the infuse light. So for that I need the possessed perk. Do I have any of them? Well, I don't. I can't infuse the light into my weapon right now and show you how cool this is. So as you can see, the light, by the way, I hope you are not bothered by the flashing lights here. So as you can see, this is kind of like a challenge run for me right now. This is so crazy with the Sonic speed. So what I like to do is just use this character here to maneuver around the place and see how much I can go for. With the infused light you get a better light because it's white. I don't know, I mostly like to do this around here. So as you can see, the lightning effects are very good in the game. Yeah, so after a hard boss fight... Well, I killed all of them. After a hard boss fight like that one, I just have to relax a bit more. And this is a good way of doing it, in my opinion. Steady now, steady. Ah, I'm out of stamina. Anyway, see you next time. Bye!